of the hour. We will get underway here. Thank you so much for the crew who joined Saturday morning. We are delighted to have Dr. Maarten Naesens from Leuven this morning, morning in Boston and afternoon in Belgium, and some time of the day and across the world. So without further ado, Dr. Naesens, the mic is yours.
Thank you so much, Kassem, and thank you all for listening on this Sunday afternoon for me, morning for many of you, indeed, on microvascular kidney transplant inflammation or rejection. So I would like to start with a very superficial overview of what we see in the field of kidney transplantation in terms of outcome, where over the past 30 years, we have seen a tremendous improvement of the one-year graft survival, but even more, the 10-year graft survival has improved quite impressively if you take into account the standard transplants patient. But however, quite a lot of patients are not transplanted with standard kidneys and are transplanted, for instance, with antibody positive, DSA positive organs, or also, for instance, organs from elderly donors. So the outcome that you see depicted on this slide is not always happening in all cases. And for instance, in Leuven, in our cohort, nicely mentioned by Kassem, we have very good track records of why do patients fail their kidneys over time after transplantation. And what we see on the one hand is that very often in the earliest phase post-transplantation, non-function mechanical issues occur and can lead to urgent loss of the kidneys. But what we see very often on the longer term post-transplantation that a lot of kidneys fail because of immune responses and rejection phenomena. And a lot of kidneys also fail in the apparent absence of clear rejections. But if you look back to those patients that have successive biopsies, like the protocol biopsies that we do with chronic injury, if you then trace back what happened in the past of these patients, very often you see that they have experienced prior rejection episodes, clearly illustrating that rejection and inflammation of kidney transplants is still a major problem in our field, despite the use of powerful immunosuppressants. A few years ago, we have done on our large cohort a study trying to decipher what are the risk factors for graft failure in multivariable Cox models. And as you can see, one of the items that we included in the multivariable models was microvascular inflammation, was an independent predictor of graft failure. And also the iBox score produced by the Paris transplant group has looked or is trying to predict graft failure after kidney transplantation. And if you look carefully at the independent risk factors for graft failure, glomerulitis and peritubular capillaritis are both included in the multivariable risk score for prediction of graft failure, again, illustrating that this entity of microvascular inflammation, glomerulitis and peritubular capillaritis is indeed contributing to the outcome of the patients. So I mentioned several times inflammation, microvascular inflammation and rejection. In all honesty, rejection today, despite the fact that we have a lot of new tools, non-invasive markers, rejection is diagnosed primarily in biopsies. And for that, the international consensus is to use the Banff classification. In September 2022, we had the last Banff 2022 meeting in Canada. And so part of the session today, I will devote to the session that we had at the Banff meeting, specifically discussing the microvascular inflammation entity. Very briefly, the Banff classification is focusing on the disease diagnosis and also disease stage and severity, the activity, chronicity of the disease. I will focus also the presentation today specifically on the diagnosis by a light microscopy of the entity of microvascular inflammation. I will not go into the non-invasive diagnostics. I will also not go into the issue of the molecular transplant diagnostics, also the transcriptomic analysis of kidney transplant biopsies. The Banff classification, in my opinion, is trying to put the patients with a biopsy into different disease categories. And when we look at the biopsy, primarily have different lesions that are seen as the most specific and for different disease entities. And these lesions are glomerulitis and peritubular capillaritis on one hand, and interstitial inflammation, tubulitis on the other hand. Next to these inflammatory lesions, we of course also assess chronic lesions, but that's not the topic of today. What we do in the Banff classification is that we a bit artificially perhaps split microvascular inflammation, glomerulitis and peritubular capillaritis from tubular interstitial inflammation. And the tubular interstitial inflammation we typically attribute to T-cell mediated rejection, while the microvascular inflammation is often considered to be relevant in antibody-mediated rejection.